Hi, it's Sarah, and I'm here today. We're going to talk about what you're going to need if you want to follow along in my painting tutorial. I kind of figure out a way to get everybody on the same page with this. These little items here are little wood pieces that you can buy at Michael's. They come like this. They're in the little kids section. Near the wood. So they're a dollar a piece. I got the mermaid and I got this little sunflower. So if you want to paint along, you can go ahead over to your Michael's and see if they have those. They had a ton at mine, so I have a cold. I'm sorry. All right. So I want to talk about the supplies you're going to need to make these items. So first thing, obviously, you're going to need is paint. And I just got this Americana set. It's over in the aisle with all the paint. They have Americana and they have Ceram Coat. But this is a nice set for, it was around five something, but with a coupon you could get it for, 40% off. And this has 16 colors. And I liked it because it had a couple of variations, so we can shade and highlight, and had a little bit more to play with. So I opted for that. I mean, any paint that you have in your stash at the moment, you can make these any colors you want. I just made them these colors, but just to get the techniques and all that stuff across, you just can use any kind of paint. And you don't even have to paint on these. You can just use watercolor paper. You probably have that in your stash, or anything you have, any little piece of wood. This is just, I just left it raw on the back, but I'd like to go through and show you how to prep a piece of wood. So as for that, I mean, you don't have to go get it, but I would use either varnish, or I use all-purpose sealer, which is a product, this is the Joe Sonia brand, which I've painted for years, so I ordered this online. But you can mix 50-50. It's half the blue and half the varnish. Mix that together, and that's going to seal the piece for you, so that when you base coat the piece, which will look like this, it's just going to seal the wood, because wood is a porous surface. And so what you're left with is a nice clean slate to start with, and your paint isn't going to seep into the wood or cause any type of, because sometimes it brings the nap of the wood up too when you add acrylic paint to it. So I'm going to go through how you prep the piece too. Of course, you're going to need a couple brushes. So I'm going to try and get you through this with four different brushes. And those will be, and I'm going to put this in the description box, at least a half inch, if not bigger. This is the smallest I would like you to go with for the angle brush, because this is for a technique called floating, and you really do need to have a biggish brush. This is my go-to. I use the 5/8 inch size. So you can see this brush holds a lot of water, and you can really get it to do what you want to do. You can't use a little teeny tiny brush to get that technique. So that's for shading and highlighting. Then a number 8, at least these are by American Painter too. They definitely sell these at Michael's and AC Moore. They're around $3 a piece, something like that. This is an 8 flat. They call it a shader, a number 8 shader. Gonna need that for base coating. We have a number 3 round. This is, yep, a number 3 round. Number 4 would be fine too, 3 or 4. 2 might be a little small. And then this is a number 1 liner. A script is a bit longer. The bristles are longer in a script, but they'll do the same thing. It's for detail work. So you're going to need those four brushes. I have a palette knife as well. Oh, a stylus. You probably have a stylus in your stash. I like to use this for dip dots, like these little dots that go all around the outside of here. You make those. Tracing on your pattern, you use a stylus. We can use a pencil, you'll be fine. This is a mop brush, and they may sell these at Michael's. I'm not sure. I've had mine forever. I actually used a makeup brush when I first started painting and didn't know any better, but there is a little bit something to it. You don't want the bristles to be too soft. You need a little bit of firmness to them, but this is to actually do that technique I was talking about, to shade and highlight. You need to mop up the water, so it helps to get that nice shaded effect. If you can get by without this, but that's a tool I definitely would have in my stash if I were gonna paint. And I have palette knife, so this is just to grab your paint out with. You don't need a palette knife, but if you've done anything with texture paste and things like that, you probably have a palette knife in your stash. A pencil, you're gonna need a pencil to trace your pattern with. Sorry, I'm really not, I didn't know my voice was gonna be like this. A water bucket. I still have my dirty water in here because I think I'm gonna go over how to base coat, and I figured why clean my water before I do that. Let's see, I'm gonna need some tracing paper. That is, and these are the Canon or Canson brand from Michaels, and it's just your basic tracing paper. You may have that in your stash for whatever reasons, but you know, it's that see-through paper that you can trace a pattern on with. And the final, well, it's not, maybe not the final, I'll have to look. A paper palette. Now, the difference between a palette, you could use like this, you could use this for your palette to put your paint in. You can, I'm gonna use a styrofoam plate. That's what I choose to use for my palette, just to squirt your paint onto, to have your paint on here. And then I work the brush into the paper palette. The paper palette's like a waxy surface. And in order to load your brush, I use this to load my brush with, but it is an essential tool in acrylic painting, the type of decorative painting that I do. I would definitely, if you want it to look, I mean, actually, you know what? I was just thinking you might be able to use your craft mat. I think you could probably use your craft mat for that technique. That just occurred to me. I might have to try that and see, so that you guys don't have to get a wet palette, because you could wipe this off when you're done. A paper palette. You're gonna need Q-tips. Q-tips are just a little go-to if you mess up. You could just, I lick it, but people may not want to lick it. and just to get your mistakes off. An eraser, which you probably already have in your stash as well. I just use this Paper Mate Pink Pearl to get the graphite. Oh, I forgot about the graphite. In order to trace the pattern onto your piece, we'll be tracing the pattern from the paper to this tracing paper, and then you're gonna trace that onto your piece with graphite. And there's white and black. A well-used piece of graphite is your best bet. If not, you're just gonna push lightly and you'll be okay. And I think that's pretty much it for the supplies. I'm gonna list these, like I said, in the description box. I have another minute or so, and real quick, decorative painting, the type that I did, was done by someone else creates the design. So see, I've painted this several times. I made this on a tissue box, this little, and this is designed by Lynn Deptula and Judy Dipehouse. They're distinctive brush strokes. They're out of Michigan, and this is their book. This is their designs in here. So what I like about their designs is they have these nice step-by-step color examples of how to get the techniques. You can't go wrong with that, I swear. Like, there's another page here I had. Back here they have the flowers. So how to base your petals and get that look, how to do the strokes even. So if you can find a book that has that type of detail in it, you can't go wrong, really. I mean, it's the best way to go. They have great line work. I love their designs too. So I'll talk more about that while I'm base coating and showing you guys what to do. So here's the look. It's well used, but that's the pattern for that little, like I said, oh, doing this little honey jar was so cool. So all right, get your supplies, gather your supplies, and come back, and I'll have the next step after that. All right, guys? Thanks for watching.